Okay, touch the glove. Back to the corner.
Final instructions from our center referee, Kim Ching. Will Peter Pan, Yang Fei, fly high in the Never Never Land of One Championship on debut? Or will the jungle cat, Muhammad Aiman, spoil the party? We're inside the massive Singapore Indoor Arena. It's Immortal Pursuit. Both men in orthodox stance. You can see the height and reach differential going the way of the jungle cat.
Like Aiman's movement right away, he's feinting a lot, moving left and right, throwing out the jab, really just trying to get that distance of the shorter athlete.
Fake off the back leg there from the jungle cat and fakes the right hand. Up on the balls of his feet. Such long legs and long arms here on Muhammad Aiman. Looks for the rib cage as Aiman. High left roundhouse kick from Peter Pan, Yang Fei. Looking to stay in control of center cage here, Yang Fei, and force Aiman to the outside. Lots of fakes and feints, in and out movement here from the jungle cat, Muhammad Aiman, Mitch.
He's really able when he throws that jab, when he throws that feint, just to kind of see what Yang Fei does as he sets that up. He goes really well to the head and to the body, and also attacks the legs quite well.
Aiman circling away from the power side of Yang Fei, that being the right side of the orthodox combatant. Jab two there from Muhammad Aiman, and he takes control of center cage, trying to take his head off with that high right roundhouse.
Really showing lots of different attacks, mixing things up quite well, so Yang Fei can't quite get a read on it. He attacks the lower leg for a beautiful trip.
Okay. Good timing on the leg kick there from Muhammad Aiman. Still circling, as he should be, to Yang Fei's left. Jab two, roundhouse kick, top of the thigh there from the jungle cat. We are seeing an intriguing opening stanza. Fake again from Aiman. Do you like these fakes and feints the jungle cat's doing here, Mitch?
I do, because it gives him an idea of what exactly Yang Fei is going to react to. What's he going to do when he throws out that feint, when he throws out that jab? How is Yang Fei going to react, and what's that going to plan for? And that's going to set up his next attack. And that's what's leading to these leg kicks, these lower leg trips that we're seeing. And he's also attempting to go high, so he's consistently mixing up his combinations.
As we see more and more tremendous Chinese athletes enter one championship and get victories, the likes of Mahal Bin and Rockman Chen Li. In our last contest, Miao Li Tao on debut. Can Yang Fei keep the Chinese trend going here? Outside leg kick from Aiman.
Leg kick seems to be his most effective weapon. He hasn't quite found the range with the punches yet, so he's still trying to look for that perfect distance to attack with the hands. When he closes the distance, that's when he gets tagged, though.
Jab two, and a two on full extension from Muhammad Aiman. Flicks up a, wasn't really a front kick, more of a punt kick there from Aiman. Still circling counterclockwise. Now, although that's the way that Aiman should be going, he's got to be careful not to make it too telegraphic so that Yang Fei can time something on him, Mitch.
Yeah, that's what he's got to worry about. He's landing over and over, but he's consistently mixing up the attacks. There he is, landing again that leg kick. That seems to be his most effective weapon. Now, what I would like to see is maybe go up high, land a punch, or at least fake the punch, and then go up high with that head kick.
Fakes an uppercut, far too far away for it though, does Yang Fei. Aiman goes to the body, his corner saying, give me something, and he responds, another good outside leg kick. He's really gone to town on that lead leg of Peter Pan, Yang Fei.
And we're going to slowly start to see Yang Fei drop that left hand, and that's going to lead to a nice setup for a high kick. Aiman's got a lot of experienced grapplers out there at Bali MMA, but he prefers to entertain and stand on his feet. He likes to bang.
Yang Fei will relish an opportunity to go to ground should it come. At the moment, we're seeing a glorified kickboxing contest between these two. Yang Fei does have a BJJ blue belt. No chance to use it yet. Looks to get on the inside with a short hook there, does Muhammad Aiman.
They both seem very comfortable to stand in the middle and trade. Aiman seems to be the more active athlete, really dishing out the combinations. But every time he comes into range, to that boxing range, Yang Fei is able to stick out that left hook or that jab. And he's connecting once Aiman enters that boxing range.
What seems to be confounding Yang Fei a little more is the constant movement here of Muhammad Aiman. He's not a sitting target, he's not stagnant. Fakes again, does the Malaysian. Goes to the outside, lead leg, being the prime weapon. There's one more, and that lead leg buckles a little. Aiman on the inside, goes the liver, goes the leg kick. Succulent combinations from the Jungle Cat. Tremendous opening round for Muhammad Aiman out of Bali MMA. And you know, the Leone brothers watching this one back in Bali are going to be cheering loudly.
So, interesting first round. Aiman was able to land again over and over that lead leg kick. He sets it up really well, times off at every single exchange. Boom, there he is, sweeping out the low leg right as Yang Fei puts pressure on that front leg. Bang, bang. Beautiful 1-2 combination, lands the left leg kick again. But what I'm excited about, not only do we have legend versus legend, but we've got another legend on the commentary booth with us, Rich Franklin. And how did you have that one scored?
I'm just excited to be here with two rock stars in this booth. I'll tell you, the last highlight there of Aiman pretty much tells the story of this first round. I have this basically scored right now in the striking superiority category. Iman's able to put punches and bunches in him with kicks, you know, so he's able to 2-3 pieces at the same time. And that's starting to lead, that striking superiority is starting to lead into the damage category. You can see the blood on Yang Fei's nose. So I'm starting to score him even in the higher categories at this point in time. He's ahead on the scorecards.
Second round set for 3. Tremendous opener for the Jungle Cat, Muhammad Aiman. Circled off to his left for almost the first time in this contest there, Aiman. Then I think he thought to himself, whoops, going the wrong way, and drifts back to his right. Thought about the leg kick to the back leg on that occasion. Those long limbs of Aiman will allow him to get around the back and kick that rear thigh, rear hamstring.
Well, Yang Fei's pretty much flat-footed right now, and he's putting a lot of weight on that lead leg, so we can expect more of the same that we saw in the first round. Aiman just to chew up that lead leg.
The more Muhammad Aiman bangs up the lead leg of Yang Fei, the harder it's going to be for Yang Fei to shoot in on him. As Mitch said, Peter Pan very flat-footed at the moment. Big outside leg kick again, thumps it to the lead thigh, damaging those quadriceps.
It'll be interesting to see how he reacts to that leg being chewed up like that again. Is he going to set up anything else? Is he going to go after the head, or is he going to start to go after the body, or is he just going to stay there and beat that lead leg up?
I would stay there, Mitch. You see, Yang Fei shown no signs of checking that kick, of switching stars to protect that left leg. I'd keep going after it, just chopping down.
Let's see if he listens to that advice. Okay. But Aiman's got really clever hands. He really has a nice stiff left jab. And he's got a nice, beautiful, straight right hand. He mixes it up a little bit more, but he doesn't seem to need to because that lead leg kick is working so well.
That lead thigh turning a shade of red of Yang Fei. He's got to start protecting that left leg. There's a takedown attempt from Yang Fei for the first time. Can he get Aiman on his back? Aiman posts up well on the right arm. Back to his feet. Looks for a time for to step back and not chase Yang Fei. Was that the right move to make?
Nice little takedown attempt because he was, Aiman gets a little bit more aggressive. He might start swinging and Yang Fei might duck under again. But nice wizard control for Aiman to get back up to his feet.
Aiman circling to the left side of Yang Fei again. If it does go to ground, look out for the side control position on Muhammad Aiman, especially the knee on belly. He's very proficient at it. Has some very solid ground and pound. Also has 5 submissions as an amateur. Very slick triangle or armbar off his back. So well equipped is Muhammad Aiman on the ground, which is where Yang Fei needs to get him, because in the stand-up, Jungle Cat is owning him, Mitch.
And the Jungle Cat is very good at judges' decisions. He likes to push things deep into the third round, and he's got to secure a little bit more activity on this part. Because right now, Yang Fei's getting back into this, but Yang Fei's got to be more active. Aiman slowed down just a little bit. You can see him not circling so much as he did in the first round. He slowed down a little bit, but we're not seeing the action that we saw in the first round.
The stance of Aiman is something to behold as well. See the way he tucks the chin, he looks through the brow, he's got the left shoulder raised to offer more protection. Really good boxer's guard here from Muhammad Aiman. Corner of Aiman saying, you've got to come forward. Don't let Yang Fei establish any momentum. Go back to that lead leg, Mitch. He hasn't gone there as much here in the second round as he did in the first.
And he's more just touching the leg. He's almost patting it with the ball of his foot, not really coming out and digging his chin into that leg. And these close distances are enabling Yang Fei, like he did, to get the clinch.
It was a four-punch combination that got Aiman on the side. Yang Fei seemed to shake them off and look for the body clinch to takedown. Couldn't affect it, but just gave Aiman a taste of what it's like to be in the pocket with him. Corner of the Jungle Cat saying, hands and feet, hands and feet. They want to see more combinations.
Yang Fei's not really doing too much. If Aiman can just kind of put the pedal to the metal a little bit and shift it up into a higher gear and be a bit more active, but he's also slowing down as well.
Mitch, what are you telling Peter Pan to do right now?
Peter Pan's got to be more active. Because you can see that Aiman is slowing down. He's not as active as he was in the first round. So this is his chance to really start using his punches and his kick combinations. But when he does attack, he's only throwing one shot at a time. He's not really putting anything together.
Aiman lands some more blows on the thighs of Yang Fei. And we go to the towels at the end of two. Wherever you're watching our prelims, hope you're enjoying them. It's one championship. Immortal Pursuit. We're later tonight in our main event. Undefeated world welterweight champion Ben Askren takes on challenger Shinya Aoki. Ben Askren's final ever bout. Can the champion retire undefeated? Rich Franklin, take us through this.
This is how I have it scored up to this point in the match. You know, most of the aggression points that Aiman had there was in the first round. He's doing a great job defending the takedown, the striking superiority, obviously, we talked about in the first round. But that damage is starting to accumulate, not just the blood in the nose from the first round, but you can see the leg kicks are starting to add up. Yang Fei is starting to be really heavy on that front leg. He's not moving as much, but again, neither is Aiman. However, after two rounds, this is where I have the score.
It is all for the Jungle Cat, Muhammad Aiman, to do in the third and final round. Great crowd continues to file in here to the Singapore Indoor Arena. We're almost full already. You can see the glow sticks around this massive auditorium. And they are in for an absolutely magnificent night of martial arts action.
Ready.
Kim Chen gets us underway, fourth and final. The tall, lanky Jungle Cat from Indonesia, Muhammad Aiman. The shorter, stockier Peter Pan Yang Fei from China. You see Yang Fei finally attempted to check one of those leg kicks. Didn't quite execute it correctly though. That lead leg has taken all sorts of punishment, particularly in the first round. That was a good counter from Peter Pan Yang Fei.
He's moving well. He likes to throw a kick and then counter with a punch, but he's usually out of range for that second shot, so it's easy for Aiman just to avoid it and then come right back with something of his own.
Both men trading jabs, shoots him for a double deuce. Yang Fei. Why isn't Yang Fei able to land these double leg takedowns, Mitch?
Well, he's kind of just shooting in at the waist, so it's easy for Aiman to get his underhooks to control to defend properly. So he's not really attacking the legs, but he's also not really setting them up very well. He's shooting from so far away that it's telegraphed, and it's easy for Aiman to pick it off.
Action.
This is Muhammad Aiman's first time ever competing in Singapore. Hasn't traveled well on the road so far, the Jungle Cat. He is 0-2 in bouts outside of Malaysia thus far. But he's certainly looking at a victory here. Just under 3.5 minutes to go. Good right hand tags the jaw of Yang Fei. Yang Fei looks for a takedown. Gets it. Now can he keep the Jungle Cat on his back?
Nice body lock takedown to get Aiman to the ground. Now he looks like he's in full mount now. Aiman's got to elevate off the hip. He's trying to walk up the wall. trying to go out the back door. Sneaky from Aiman, but good control from Yang Fei to end up on top. I wonder how this is going to shift this late into the contest.
Aiman back to his feet now. Yang Fei is back. What can Muhammad Aiman do from here? And he says, get up, Peter Pan. Great defense from the Jungle Cat. There was a moment there, a snifter of hope on the ground for Yang Fei. We are back to a striking contest.
Since he wasn't able to hold Aiman down and control that position, I don't think it's going to reflect enough on the judges' scorecards.
Past the halfway mark of this third and final round, our one championship bout has scored overall, not round by round. And so far, you'd have to have Muhammad Aiman ahead, but there is still time for Peter Pan to find something. Outside leg kick after the left hook. There's another one from Aiman. Really saw him go to town in the first round with the leg kick. Not so much in the second, little here in the third.
So effective, Michael. He's probably landed 9, 10, 12 of the beautiful leg kicks. And now to see him completely abandon his most successful weapon strikes me as odd. But when he does get into range, you can see that as soon as Yang Fei sees him come in, he counters with a really nice left hook.
Trying for the headache maker, the high right roundhouse there, Muhammad Aiman. You can hear the corner of Aiman saying, go back to that leg kick, it's the prime weapon. And it's interesting what the corner are telling him to do here. They're saying, don't load up with the leg, just slap and go, slap and go. So hit the leg, move off, don't put all your eggs in that basket of the leg kick.
Yang Fei's very heavy on that lead leg. He's put a lot of pressure on it. And he was so effective in the first round. There he is again, but he's loading up on it.
High guard against the roundhouse kick from Yang Fei. Under a minute to go now. Switch up roundhouse kick there from Muhammad Aiman. Yang Fei is in turn. Aiman went hit hunting again. Corner of Aiman know that so long as he doesn't do anything silly, he should have this match in the bag. Fakes the right hand, goes for a left hook to the body. Aiman slipping there. Yang Fei couldn't capitalize. It looks like Muhammad Aiman tried for a couple of air kicks. Looks like he may get his first ever victory on the road here. Beautiful combination again. The Jungle Cat, another capoeira style technique, an exquisite display of striking from the man out of Bali MMA.
Very good third round. He was very active. The kick, he started to put combinations together. So he was going to the body, going up top, and then coming down low. Here's some of the exchanges where Aiman goes out the back door. Very sneaky, but good pressure from Yang Fei. I would have liked to see him try to initiate more scrambles, get close, keep it nice and tight, but Aiman did a good job at defending. Rich Franklin, how did you have that one?
This is much the same as it was last time. You know, Yang Fei, the most significant thing he did in this match was that takedown. But he didn't spend enough time on the ground to actually really close the distance in the discrepancy between the two of them. You know, even though Aiman slowed down, he was still landing one shot here, one shot there. Basically controlled most of that round, added to his lead. I have him ahead on the scorecards.
Don't forget, folks, massive main event happening tonight. Ben Askren versus Shinya Aoki. It's legend versus legend. But right now, let's go to Dominic Lau to find out this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of the following scoring on the judges' scorecards, all three judges have scored this round in favor of the competitor by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Muhammad Aiman.
Muhammad Aiman, very impressive in a very cerebral contest. The Jungle Cat wins by unanimous decision.